Divine light of the sun. Today we'll have a couple of practical sessions. Can switch off the fans.
That's okay. Yeah. This man is making good of sound.
Okay. So today I am going to teach you a couple of practices which you can take home and do. First is about meditation practice. Okay? So the meditation, our nervous system has three parts: the spinal cord, the middle portion, and upper portion. So the spinal cord is more related to what you call as a reptilian nervous system, or it is common to lizards, okay, where it's more for survival, fight and flight. Middle part of the nervous system is more for animals. We are actually a combination of animals, lizards, and human beings, where there is a community living, love, some sort of affection is there. And higher part of the nervous system is what for human beings. That's what has given us logic, reasoning, science and technology. Now, there is a further evolution possible in the human nervous system, with the human nervous system. At this center is called Ajna Chakra, and at this center is called Brahmananda. These are the two centers which give further evolution. So now, for the evolution to take place, the energy has to flow there. Without the energy flowing there, there's no evolution possible. Now, most of the time, our day-to-day existence is only dependent on fight or flight, survival. Okay? And to some less and less energy goes for evolution. Right? And energy required for evolution of the nervous system to form more neuronal connections, more connections at these centers is less. Actually, this is why the tikka is put here, the naam, because that is the center where further evolution can take place. Okay? Now, what is that evolution is about? With the human body mind complex, you can experience the superconscious state. With the nervous system, you can experience the superconscious state. And when you say superconscious state, very simple peace and serenity. You can experience. That's why you always put that tikka. Okay? So that is the purpose of this center. The nervous system, a part of the nervous system which can experience peace, silence, and serenity is here. Then this center is called Brahmananda. Okay? Which is actually when you are born as a child, this center was open. There's a soft plate here. Okay? And there was energy flow up and down at this center. Even the child is 3 months, 4 months, I don't know how long. The child, its plate is soft. So there, the opening is there. Okay? That gets closed after some time. And that is the point of time we start gradually feeling disconnected from the universal consciousness, universal energy. Okay? So the key to merger or oneness with the higher consciousness are these two centers. Whereas we operate mostly in the spinal cord, which is reptilian, which is fight or flight, food, sex, survival, okay, some amount of emotions, and some amount of reason and logic. Now, only in human beings, what has happened? It's a, the reasoning and logic is always for food, sex, and survival. The higher intelligence operates for the lower. So, as spiritual evolution says you have to surrender. Surrender means you have to come out of this game of fight, flight, survival. So when you come out of the game, that energy available is available for you to higher evolution. That's where the meditation and all those things take place. As long as you are fighting in the lower game, so that evolution doesn't take place. Okay? Now I will teach you two practices which you can take. First is just observe the breath. Okay. Now those who have difficulty in observing the breath, they lose the consciousness, like Narayan. I will give you an example, right? If you are losing the focus, you keep your left hand on the stomach. Okay, so you observe the movement of the breath in the stomach. Those who are comfortable observing the breath in the nose, you observe that. and pay attention to, there's a gap between the two breaths, in breath and out breath. There's a movement, stopping, stopping outside, stopping inside. Just stay there for 1 second extra, without forcing, in that stopping period. Understand? When the breath stops, the mind stops. So as you become aware of that stopping, the mind becomes more and more silent. Is it clear? Now, start. Okay, so first take a couple of deep breaths. Take deep breath with the eyes closed. Okay. As you take deep breath, mind becomes silent. Mind and breath are related. Take deep breath into abdomen. Slow breath, deep breath. As you take slow breath and deep breath, the mind becomes deeply silent. Slow breathe out. Slow breathe in, slow breathe out. When you breathe in and breathe out, just pause for a second when after you breathe out. When the breath goes out, just pause for a second. Watch that pause, gap between two breaths. You can see the mind becomes silent in that gap. Slow, deep breathe in, breathe out. With the gap in between, slow, deep breathe in, out. So, gap in between. You can see suddenly you become deeply silent. Breathe in, breathe out, with a pause in between. Now, become aware of natural breathing, no forceful inhalation, exhalation. Become aware of your natural breathing pattern. Become aware of your natural breathing pattern. You can keep your hands on thighs in a crossed fashion. Become aware of the natural breathing. Mind becomes deeply silent. As you become aware of natural breathing, mind becomes deeply silent. Experience that peace and silence. Become aware of natural breathing. As you become aware of natural breathing, experience the peace and silence. wind may slow down slightly or perhaps even stop. When the breath stops, the mind stops. When the breath stops, the mind stops. Become aware of the breathing. The breath slows down and mind stops. When there is a breath stopping, when the mind stops, there is pure consciousness, the witness, which is your true nature. The witness alone shines. You are not the body, mind, or intellect. You are the witness of the body, mind, and intellect. You are the sakshi, the witness. The body, mind, and intellect belong to creation. You are of the nature of pure consciousness, the creator. Asato ma,
asato ma,
sarvamaya,
sarvamaya,
tamaso ma,
tamaso ma,
jyotirgamaya,
jyotirgamaya,
vatyorma,
vatyorma,
amrutam gamaya,
amrutam gamaya,
om shanti 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 vi,
om shanti 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 vi.
Let there be peace.
and then peace,
both in us, all in beings, land,
sea,
forest,
forest,
and sky, all beings. लोकाः समस्ताः सुखिनः भवन्तु लोकाः समस्ताः सुखिनः भवन्तु लोकाः समस्ताः सुखिनः भवन्तु हरिः ॐ श्रीगुरुभ्यो
नमः
Hari Om.
Hari Om.
For open eyes. Rub your hands. You warm your eyes. Don't rub. Just you warm with eye muscles. And open your eyes. So this is one step of meditation. Is it clear to you? So anybody had any difficulty? Any questions? Anybody felt ease? Anybody felt sleeping? Okay. So there's ease and silence? Okay. You can do as much time as possible. Okay, but not after food. Give some gap. Anybody has a question about this, or we proceed to the next step?
So when you say natural, there is, you don't observe the gap.
Natural is just the gap. You don't observe the gap.
Or even there you don't observe the gap?
Yeah. A small gap.
Yes, sir.
So
you say that breathing stops. It's just a, when you say breathing stops, mind stops. The breathing is there.
No, I'm saying do for a longer period of time. It stops. You slow down. And perhaps it stops. Very small demand.
Full breathe those kind of stuff. Breathing, taking the weekend.
Any questions? my mind becomes silent and I experience the peace and silence. So prayer or sankalpa you can do before meditation. Now I just show you small clipping of effect of prayer or sankalpa. Okay.
I'll open paper on this.
You not a
public knowledge. Correct, correct.
Okay, that's a 3 minute clipping. Just quickly watch this. So this is done by a doctor called, a scientist called Dr. Emoto. Let's see the face.
Really slow.
Okay. So this is actually the power of intention, or sankalpa. So you have, do you have the ability to change anything in the world? Your sankalpa. Our mind has the ability. What he did is, he took water, a glass of water, and had different types of intentions in front of the water. And then he had a deep freezing, rapid deep freezing of the water. So when you do rapid deep freezing, they say water molecules get crystallized, and each crystallized molecule has a different shape, different structure. So the music, words, and spoken words are typed. And this experiment has been done in multiple countries with multiple languages, and everywhere the result is same. The response of the water to the thoughts. This is a bit slow because I'm playing directly from the internet.
Resolution. thing.
So this is when you have a word called love in front of water, the crystal just provides. Okay. Anyway, thank you. The words of thanks, gratefulness, thanks, the crystal structure is of this nature. And the water is rapidly frozen. And this doesn't depend on the language, it depends on the emotion and feeling what a person says. Hitler, gratitude. Samples of this is actually became quite popular, and they experimented, they repeated in multiple countries with multiple different types of water. So the water crystal has a strange property that it's unique in nature, like our fingerprints are unique. No two people have a single fingerprint. Similarly, the crystalline structure is also different. So what was observed is that after exposure to a certain thought process, the water crystalline structure changes. And with positive emotions, positive feelings, the molecular structure is different, the crystalline structure is different. With the negative thoughts or emotions of negativity, the thought structure, the water structure is different, water molecular structure is different. So what does it mean? What does it mean to you?
So
brain cells.
Okay. Yeah.
So body contains 70-80% water.
Yes.
So brain also is the space of water.
Right.
Cells. So when you meditate, we have peace and happiness. The crystallization happens there as well.
Your body chemistry changes when you meditate. First thing. Because you are putting 80% water. Second, your thought process affects somebody who is around you also. The positive and negative thought process affects people around you also, because this applies to water, but this applies to all elements of nature in general. So human beings have the ability to affect the environment and nature through thought process. That is the conclusion. So which also means that the way you are, what your emotions are, your feelings are, you are affecting the environment and vice versa. You are getting affected. Which means you also have the ability to change the world in a better way by your prayer, meditation, by your presence. Okay? So this is the summary. This is why people find that the enlightened beings are there, people find some solace and peace in their presence. Because their peace and energy which they radiate, people feel that instinctively deep inside. Okay? So first, let us understand the intention. Intention is a conscious decision. This is why I am doing meditation. Okay? So that can be for your job, for your family, all those things you can possibly. Right? Sankalpa should be always clear. Otherwise, sankalpa is not clear. Consciously you think of something, subconscious something else will happen. You have to align conscious, subconscious, superconscious. Okay? So then when you have sankalpa is for universal benefit, it is all the three gets aligned. So let us do the sankalpa now and do the same meditation what we did earlier. Okay, at the end of meditation we again say that all beings in the universe be happy and peaceful. So because our mind has become peaceful, we are one with the super conscious mind, and because we are one with super conscious mind, we will be able to affect a larger part of the universe. Even though you are here, your mind affects many more beings. Okay? So now why do you want to do this meditation for? That let's make the sankalpa clear. Can somebody say why you want to do meditation?
The sankalpa is?
Huh?
Sankalpa
you have to say that.
No, that's universal sankalpa.
The universal sankalpa will affect universally, individual sankalpa will affect individually.
But we need to now say, we need to have each sankalpa.
Yeah, I'm giving example now. So what do you want to do sankalpa? I'm just giving example so that you can practice in your house. So the sankalpa can be made as a prayer, or sankalpa can be made as an instruction. Alright. So it can be sankalpa or it can be prayer. So first let us make a prayer. I am going to practice
meditation
to experience
peace,
bliss,
enlightenment
in my life,
and share
the joy
of
peace,
love,
and bliss.
With the universe
for the welfare of
all living beings.
Please
bless me
with a beautiful
meditation.
So this is prayer. So this prayer is for super conscious mind. Now if you have to do as a sankalpa, which is as an instruction, not as a prayer, I'll change the little bit so that you understand the difference between the prayer and sankalpa.
I am going to practice
meditation
for next
25 minutes. During this period,
my mind will be cool, calm,
and silent.
For experiencing
peace,
the peace
and bliss of
supreme
reality. So you understand the difference between the instruction and the prayer. Instruction is for the subconscious mind. The prayer is for the superconscious mind. Prayer is more larger because it goes to subconscious mind and goes to the conscious. Clear? So now we will do the same meditation what we did earlier. Okay? You, so that I am just going to make you practice a little bit. Okay? It's clear to everybody? So do that now. Sit comfortably. Sankalpa can mean anything. Yeah, but you understand the difference sankalpa and prayer.
Still, when you say it was clear, but I'm not doing it clear.
Why?
So basically, what was the difference actually?
Sankalpa is what I am going to do. It's a conscious mind.
What
telling.
Words are?
Huh?
Words are?
Words are actually for, a prayer is for a higher consciousness.
Okay.
Right? Prayer is you are seeking. For the subconscious, you are instructing.
Okay.
Right? I'll be cool, calm, and silent.
That's the instruction.
Instruction. Mm-hmm. Okay. Bless me with peace and silence. Yes.
And is it, should we do, whenever we do meditation, we should have a sankalpa?
Yes. Then it starts with a sankalpa, it starts with those with meditation, then it ends with a blessing.
Okay.
Okay.
Cannot we just sit and do one? Another word, whatever. Breathe in, breathe out, and then observe the mind.
No, see, I'm bringing some more clarity there. Okay, so that anapana, when you do, still subconscious mind to be playing some monkey tricks.
Okay.
The conscious mind has to. This is the process actually. I'm making outline the process very clearly.
Okay.
Sankalpa is conscious mind says, do this. That's the purpose. Okay.
And when we do sankalpa, is it not the mind has to be absolutely calm at that point?
No. Sankalpa is always for the conscious mind to subconscious mind.
Okay.
Yeah?
It's a decision.
It is the alignment of conscious and subconscious.
Okay. The clarity has to be so that the conscious mind.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Up to you.
Okay.
Let's start.
But as you're telling, the prayer is more in comfort.
I think it's always better than you.
Yeah, I'm bringing the distinction to you so that you're very clear.
It also covers sankalpa.
Yeah.
Prayer is
superset. Right. So let us start with the prayer now. Taking deep breath. As you take deep and slow breath, your mind becomes deeply silent. Become aware of brief pause between two breaths. momentarily for a second, just stop the breath and watch. Take deep, slow breath. Become aware of the pause in between. Now become aware of the natural breathing. Become aware of the small gentle pauses in between, gaps in between. If whatever thought comes, let it come. Just witness the thoughts. As you observe the breathing, the breath starts slowing down.
body slows down, the mind slows down. You may feel as if the mind has stopped. When the mind has stopped, it experiences deep peace, full energy. Asato ma,
asato ma,
sagamaya,
sagamaya,
tamaso
ma,
jyotirgamaya,
jyotirgamaya,
mrityorma,
mrityorma,
amrutamgamaya,
amrutamgamaya,
om shanti shanti shanti,
om shanti shanti shanti.
Let there be peace.
Let there be peace
throughout the universe.
Throughout the universe.
Let all living beings.
Let all living beings.
Land.
Land.
Sea.
Sea.
Forest.
Forest.
And sky.
And sky.
Peace.
Of peace.
Slowly open your eyes.
It was like a tingling sensation going all over like this.
Good. Mosquitoes.
And then I could, it was like as if a light was standing in front of me.
Too late.
No, not
okay. Good. So anybody has a question? Anybody else have a question? Everybody understood what is this practice is? Felt peace? Can go and practice at home? 20 minutes morning, evening.
Sometimes it's like there's a lot of absence of consciousness, like shifts between
Witnessing happens, like slowly dies.
No. Witnessing happening is the mind. Slowly dying is, even if slowly dies, you are there. That's the one witness, real witness. One is a witness, witnessing is not a witness. It's a playing the role of witness, the mind.
Okay. So the real, once it subsides, that's the thing.
Anybody has a question? Otherwise, you can go to the next step. So now, I'll show you next step. You have to have your eyes like this. So slightly above horizon. It's not this level, slightly above. And you have your eye, I touch your forehead, then feel a tingling sensation. You should be watching through the tingling sensation to a far away horizon, in a distant place. Don't get visualized as if you are seeing far away. Okay? Just try. Why do we do that? Yes. Eyes are the windows to the soul. now you rotated your eyes up, left, right, and this thing. So this eyes are connected to all parts of the brain. Brain has 360 degrees, right? So the eyes are connected to all parts of the brain. Have you understood this? Your brain is there for to show the world, right? Correct? To see the world, what are the means? Eyes and ears. Correct? So if I rotate the eyes like this, that means some part of the brain gets activated. Is it clear or not? So now, if you look at like this, a part of the brain gets activated, which is for response for higher consciousness. That also is clear? That higher consciousness is the Atma chakra. That center gets activated when you lift your eyes slightly upwards, above horizontal. First, I didn't tell about the importance of eyes, no? Now I'm telling the importance. I'm telling in four steps so that you digest each step clearly.
Why can't we do all things?
You can do that, but I'm giving you steps so that you understand the steps involved, right? Clear? So now you understand why? By lifting the eyes like this, you are activating the part of the nervous system which is responsible for higher consciousness. Clear? So that's why if you see the photographs or the pictures of the saints, many saints, they will be looking like this. They don't close their eyes, okay? But meditation, you close the eyes and do the same thing. Okay? So now that same thing you can do with your open eyes also. After you get a practice, with open eyes also you can experience the same peace. That's the idea. Just by shifting your eye position, you can experience that same peace. That's why saints' eyes are open, but they have practiced with meditation. Then with eyes open also, you can experience that same peace. Just by shifting your eyes, you can trigger that center. Have you understood? Yes or no? Everybody understood this? Huh? No. You do not feel skilled. You feel very peaceful. No. You won't feel skilled. You practice peace and the peace will come back to you. That's what I'm teaching. Yes?
But that set is looking.
That is a different one.
It's a different set. Have you everybody understood that? Say, eyes are connected to our brain. Now, the eyes are the means for, is a window to our nervous system. So shifting your eyes will open up certain centers of the nervous system. That's the reason why you hold your hand like this and in this also, because this also opens certain centers of brain. Or you hold it like this. So any posture of our body affects certain centers of the nervous system. So this you hold your body like this, one thing. Now eyes you shift like this. It's clear? So now you just see, shift your eyes like this and try to see as if you are seeing a distance. Not seeing any particular point, then throw with the eyes closed. With eyes closed. Natural. Okay? If you want to remove glasses, you can remove glasses. Close eyes. You have to bend your neck slightly backwards, tilt your neck slightly backwards, not very heavily, slight tilting. Then you will feel a tingling sensation in your forehead. Become aware of that point. So open your eyes. Everybody got what I'm saying? You got it? You didn't get it. What didn't you get?
I didn't get any sensation.
I'll teach you. Okay? Then anybody else?
Mele na kan madako, ala kattu madako, kanu na mele
na.
Oh. Not able to do that.
Not able to? Why? Why? You're doing it.
Close eyes is difficult.
You're doing it now. Just see.
Open your eyes and
do and then close. Close. That's all. Right? You are able to do it? Anybody else? Maitri? So what happens when you do that? Narayan?
You are looking into a distant area, so you are focusing the brain back into the brain.
You are focusing?
The center becomes the back of the brain.
No, center is here only. Through this point.
Yeah.
Okay, so if you do it
properly. Tingling at this part, right?
That tingling can be there also. It will be here, I will show you. Okay, tingling can be here also. But mainly it will start here. So, is it clear to you? Now we have a cup of coffee and do this meditation.